Feel. Rádio.
Indeed. Well, let's go over to Smithfield Market then. Inzi, what's happening there?
Well, Isabel, this protest started just a few moments ago. Hundreds of people sat inside the middle of Smithfield's market because this is one of the largest wholesale markets for meat and poultry in Europe, definitely the largest in the UK. So this really is a focal point for animal rebellion, not extinction rebellion, but what seems to be a sister rebellion group, Animal Rebellion, who are focusing more on the sales of meat and poultry right across the UK and the globe. Well, just step aside, you can see fairly peaceful protests. Currently, people sat down. There was a bit of drumming earlier, some singing, people speaking on the megaphone as well. There's a severe police presence here today as well, and there was in the few hours leading up to this protest a lot of police in the area just to make sure that they keep this area under control. Smithfield Markets itself actually closed. It shuts at around 10 o'clock in the morning where all the trading happens throughout the night and then shuts early morning. So Smithfield's market people won't actually be seeing this themselves, as many of the market traders will be at home and probably in bed. But the plan for Animal Rebellion is to stay up here all night, stay throughout the night, and then catch the attention of those market traders in the morning. But I'll bring in Kay Lavelle, who will probably be able to tell me a bit more about Animal Rebellion. Tell us why you're here today.
So we're here to demand a complete system change. So to actually transition into a plant-based food system, because as we now know, animal agriculture accounts for a huge, huge amount, and it causes really devastating impact on the environment, causing the whole climate catastrophe. Now, it is more than all of transport put together, and we can no longer deny it, you know, what our diet has, you know, the impact that it has on our planet. So we cannot escape this climate catastrophe if we don't transition to a plant-based food system, and we're here to show our version of the future. So we're actually opening up a massive fruit and veg market, but not only that, we've got a lot of incredible vegan and plant-based meats and cheese and plant-based desserts vendors coming here. Because we're not here to take anyone's jobs. We're not here to do anything like that. This is really very peaceful, non-violent. And we're here just to show the, you know, the workers in Smithfield
that there's a few signs that you've got up saying, you know, change to vegan, otherwise this planet will die. Why is that such an important question? Very quickly.
Unfortunately, that's the facts are all there. Animal agriculture is a destructive force to our planet. We breed billions, and I mean trillions, if you want to, you know, account for the fishing industry as well, animals into existence to feed the world over, because, you know, there's now 8 billion people to feed. So, you know, all the land that these animals take up, all the water, all the pollution, everything that goes on, all the disease that gets spread, and plus all these animals, you know, it's not a just system, it's not a nutritious system, and it's not a sustainable system.
Okay, we have to stop you there. We are out of time, but you will be here for the rest of the day and this evening, and that's their plan to stay overnight here in Smithfield's market. I'll hand back to you, Isabel.
Okay, Inzi Mam Rashid and Mark White in Trafalgar Square, thank you both very much indeed. Well, they say they want the government to tell the truth and declare a climate and ecological emergency. Parliament declared a climate emergency in May, but the protesters have described it as symbolic and non-binding. And they want the government to act now to reduce greenhouse gas emissions to net zero by 2025. And they say the current target of 2050 is a generation too late.